Okay, welcome. Today we'll be looking at conditions for aromaticity. That is to say that if a compound is presented to you and you are asked to determine whether the compound given to you is an aromatic compound or not, what are you going to do? Let's find out the qualities or the properties an aromatic compound must have. There are four conditions a compound must satisfy before we can call it an aromatic compound. Remember, aromatic compounds are those compounds that behave chemically as benzene. So, the conditions for aromaticity are, number one, the compound must be cyclic. The molecule must be cyclic. That is condition number one. It must have a cyclic structure. It should never ever be open. No open chain compound is aromatic. So that's condition number one. It must be cyclic, like a circle or like a ring. Condition number two says that an aromatic compound must be completely conjugated. Completely conjugated. And what does this mean? Being completely conjugated simply means that the compound must have double bonds in alternate positions. In alternate positions. For instance, if I have something like this, if I have this, I have carbon here, these junctions show position of carbon. Now you can see that I have a double bond here. Why here is single bond, double bond, single bond, double bond, single bond. The double bonds must be placed in alternating positions. But there are cases where you may not have a double bond here, rather you have a charge. Most of them are also aromatic. That means another way of saying that the compound must be completely conjugated is that all the carbon atoms, every carbon atom present in that molecule must be sp2 hybridized. If the hybridization of every carbon in the molecule is sp2, then it also means that the compound is completely conjugated. That's it. Now condition number three, which is second to the last condition, says that the compound or molecule must be planar in shape. It must have a planar shape. That means it must be flat. The last condition is the ultimate one, which says that the compound must obey Hooke's rule of aromaticity. It must obey Hooke's rule of aromaticity. So these are the four conditions necessary for a compound to be called an aromatic compound. If a compound survives this condition, survives this, and fails this one, automatically the compound is disqualified. For you to be qualified, you must pass the four conditions. Now, in the next video, we are going to look at what Hooke's rule is all about. Then, we'll take a look at examples of compounds that can be said to be aromatic or not. But these conditions here are the four conditions necessary for a compound to be called an aromatic compound. Once again, the compound must be cyclic. The compound must be completely conjugated, which means every carbon atom present in the compound must have sp2 hybridization. Number three says the compound must be planar, that means it must be flat. Number four says it must obey Hooke's rule of aromaticity. Click the next video to see what Hooke's rule and being completely conjugated is all about. Thank you for watching, and please do not forget to like and share our videos with your friends. Thank you.